am excited to be headed to Tulum. I've been wanting to go to this place for like years and we're finally going. But wish me luck because I went to bed at 3:30 last night and I woke up at 4:30 to go catch this flight. I always tell myself that I'm gonna be better at not packing last minute, and what did I do? I was up all night packing. I did my nails. I decided to cut a few inches off my hair. Let's head on to the airport. And mine is slightly overpacked, but who doesn't? I'm only bringing my one medium bag to check in and then a carry-on and a backpack. Now, I don't normally have my carry-on for, like, normally for international trips. I just have my medium suitcase and my backpack, but gotta bring my little mini drone with me to capture all the beautifulness of the place, so let's go. Pre-flight rosé. I think that tastes better than what you get at the Delta Lounge. Delayed about an hour, but we're on the plane. And it's a small plane.
Tray table. Be sure you fasten your seatbelt low and tight across your lap. Secure your carry-on items and put your armrests at resting position.
Well, yeah, our schedule, our first takeoff time is going to be 15 minutes from now at 40 past the hour. So that's when we should be off the ground.
It's 12:25.
And it's 2 hours and 21 minutes to get to Tulum.
We were supposed to have left at 11:15. We have to go back to the gate. It is almost 1 o'clock. We're supposed to be in Tulum right now, but we have to go back to the gate. Hello, Mexico. We're still in Atlanta. What's going on? I had my whole pillow out, ready to go to sleep when they turned the light on. Whoa, that was very aggressive. Mm-hmm.
She just like pushed that thing out of the way.
What is going on?
Are you serious?
I never had a flight this dramatic before.
Somebody else just went in there.
It's a whole line for the bathroom now.
They gotta take those people's bags off and refuel the plane.
Yeah.
I had 1 hour sleep last night.
Of all the flights I've been on, never had this much drama. Date, it's 1:26, almost 1:30. We're still here.
The bags are still there. I guess they're fueling up the plane now.
Shoot me, that's wrong.
Said short flight. It's almost 2 o'clock.
Mm-hmm.
different. Well, ask everyone to please stay seated with your seatbelts fastened and get here in 9 stones until the captain has turned off the engine, off the seatbelt sign. Be careful when opening overhead bins to avoid injury from items that may have shifted during flight. And please ensure you have all your personal belongings before deplaning today. We sincerely apologize for the delay and any inconvenience it may have caused. We appreciate your understanding and your patience. On behalf of this Atlanta and Boston based crew, we'd like to thank you for choosing Delta. We look forward to seeing you again soon. Thank you, great day, and enjoy your stay here in Tulum.
This airport looks pretty new, huh? It's 'cause it is. Very low key here. Good, he tried to get a tip at the end, like, for what, dude? I was half asleep, and then next thing I know, they were handing me towels at this hotel, and then now we're in this little sitting area.
The service and hospitality has been good so far. Huge property though. Did he give us the room keys? Oh wait, the bracelet is a room key, I forgot. My head is hurting, I'm so tired. A little welcome drink, cheers. What is this? Is this tea? It's watermelon-y.
Ready to say this?
Yep.
Sit in.
Oh. Cool.
Because you can build each of your chairs, 125, 324, right? Of the lobby, we have casas or buildings 3, 4, 5, and 6 during casa 5. And from this building here, from casa 3, we have a pool, a beach, and the left side, this is the pool. It is at the chinito for seafood from 11 a.m. to 6 p.m.
Mm-hmm.
There you will find both those ceviches.
Mm-hmm.
And next to that, there is the dinner restaurant area and the lobby. In case you want to go back to the lobby, you can do it behind the buildings or around the buildings.
Okay.
Just to keep both this friend out the way in and then the lobby. Or if you prefer the both car service, it is 24 hours. Just, you can dial here from your room. If you are asked for the both car, we will meet you at the main entrance of your building.
We just checked into the Conrad Hotel, so I'm gonna give you a little room tour. A little mini bar section. Y'all, can you tell by my eyes that I am so tired? Look, I slept 1 hour last night and then I slept an hour on the plane. And I just gotta say, the duration of the plane flight was supposed to be like 3 hours direct, less than 3 hours direct flight, but there was like an issue with some passengers on board that had to get off, and then they had to like refuel the plane because we were just sitting on the runway for so long. It was like 2 hours or more delayed, so I am super tired. Besides the point, you want to see the room. So, mini bar area, the bed, over here, I think, what is this? Oh, whoa, that's a big toilet room. And a nice shower with the view of the ocean. And also, let me see. There's a little hot tub, bathtub, right out on the balcony. And look at this view. Are you kidding? We're in Casa 5, by the way. There's, I think, maybe 6 casas, but yeah, let's go outside. Nice little tub. Oh, that's where the shower is, but you can't see through it, so you can bathe and no one can see you. The view. think the lobby is over there somewhere. And we got our own little pool there.
Now time to relax and sleep.
I hope this lighting is not too horrible. Today is Wednesday, so we're in Tulum, Mexico till next Friday. So we're here in July, which is like the seaweed season. I don't know, sarcasm. I don't know how you pronounce that word. I mean, I smell it a little bit, but I haven't really seen a lot of seaweed so far. Right now we're at the Conrad Riviera Maya. We're here for two nights. So we're going to three different hotels in total. So our first one is the Conrad, and then our second one will be Papaya Playa Projects, and then the third one will be Cannon Hotel. So the Conrad is like the farthest one away from the airport. When I routed it on Google Maps at home, it was like 45 minutes, but I think it took us, like with traffic, whatever, it took us about an hour to get here from the Tulum airport. And then the Papaya Playa Project is kind of the middle ground. It's a little bit closer to the airport, but still kind of quiet. Hopefully, I don't know yet, we'll see together. So Cannon Hotel is in the middle of the beach hotel zone area. So it would definitely be louder and less relaxing. So I'm just starting farthest away and working our way over. So the taxis around here, you know, I was watching some YouTube videos and it's not as hectic in Tulum. I don't know if it was just today. I'm here in, it's July 17th, so that's when I arrived in the afternoon. First off, it took, I don't know, like maybe 20 minutes for our bags to get off the airplane. Like everyone was just standing around waiting for the bags. And then we went outside, followed the signs for taxis, but apparently you work out the taxi deals inside. Like they have different little booths inside the airport that you book and pay through. So I just did Apple Pay because it's just safer that way. There was an ATM in the airport that withdrew some pesos just to have some. I don't think we'll be taking that many taxis. I built out this whole itinerary. If you're interested, maybe I'll put it in the description. But I kind of built out our itinerary where we won't really need taxis because I don't want to deal with that. And they charge an arm and a leg for a taxi ride. So our ride from the Tulum airport to the Conrad Hotel was like $100 USD. It was 1800 Mexican pesos. So it's up there. What else do I have to tell you? Oh, some tips. If you're interested, I have traveled a bit, so I kind of have a routine on how I do my travels. So first, of course, you have to choose your destination, and then I research when's the best time to visit that place. And then I look at flight deals and see if that coincides. And then I book the flight, and then I research hotels and areas that I want to be in and visit, and just like try to make that convenient. And then of course you have to check the weather so you know what to pack. What else? I feel like I'm missing something, but like my brain is scrambled. I am so tired. Just a bunch of research. I do a lot of research. I learn the area, what's popular around the area. Like I just learn the whole area. Like I know where I'm going. Oh, a huge tip. I always download a Google map of the area. So even if you don't have service, Wi-Fi, whatever, you know where you're at, you know where to go. I do that quite a lot. I always download a map of the whole area that I'm gonna be in, so I'm never lost. I'm sure I'll think of more tips to tell you throughout this video, so keep on watching. So far, Tulum is very much developing. Like, they have construction, the roads are getting better, I think. We drove through the center, like their little city center, which has some construction. The roads are fine, but I don't think, yeah, we haven't driven through the hotel beach zone yet, so you'll see that when I see it. You saw on the plane when we were landing, like, how much of a jungle this place is. Like, normally, like, when you're landing, you see a bunch of houses, a bunch of streets, just a bunch of buildings and roads, but landing in Tulum, it was all forest. So, I mean, you're paying for it. This Conrad Hotel is a Hilton hotel, so it's gonna be like the most mainstream hotel that we'll be at, and then the next two will be more boutique-y. I'm glad to have finally arrived. I'm gonna get some sleep tonight so we can attack tomorrow. First night in Tulum. I want to go out and explore, but I'm tired, so dinner in bed. But we're gonna pop this champagne. In French, it's Moët et Chandon, okay? So we're gonna pop this little champagne for the first night in Tulum. I'm gonna sleep good tonight, and tomorrow we're gonna go at it. For the rest of the week, I'm gonna go out and explore. But tonight, is rest. Woo! There's not even a champagne glass, but it'll work. Here's to first night in Tulum. Travel day. Gotta rest up. I'm gonna play golf tomorrow. Salad. Baja fish tacos. Arrachero tacos. Coconut shrimp ceviche. Hope it's good. Good morning from sunny Mexico. We are going to play the PGA Riviera Maya course today. But first, breakfast. Oh, that's pretty cool. Do you know where to go? Yeah, their traditional breakfast chilaquiles. Cheese or salsa. I think I want to get the French toast thing. Yeah, the breakfast buffet, you can get little fruit and stuff. I'm gonna get the signature French toast. Look at that. I added condensed milk and Nutella on top. That's really good. Cause she torched the banana. This is gonna be dangerous.
I could eat so many platefuls of this. Really good.
The mocha is pretty good. That's good. Orange juice tastes different.
It's like a milder orange juice.
That's for sure.
So we made it out here to the PGA Riviera Meyer course. We took a taxi ride from the Conrad over here, which was like 5 minute taxi ride. It was 300 pesos, about 17 US dollars. We rented some clubs. We got the little upgraded one. It starts at $65 for the rental club, but we got, and that is for the stealth, but we got the TaylorMade QI10s, which are $75. But this is a pretty nice cart, super clean. They got this little cooler of water for you, and then you can get some more. Got the first tee. Range balls are included. Yeah, so far, so good. It's a nice, sunny day. A little bit humid, but I'm used to that because, you know, Georgia weather. This is much better than Georgia weather because it's a nice breeze coming through. Now I'm gonna go practice putting and then go to the range and then we'll start playing. But this is the putting green. And also we made our tee times on golf paths, so it was like $88 or something like that per person. So check your golf pass for the deals, because I think it's normally like 100 plus a person if you just book it directly. So the greens aren't that fast, but I'm not used to this putter, so I'm getting there. Made two super long putts. Y'all didn't see it, but you just gotta trust that I did. It was from there to over there. I think maybe I'm getting the hang of it. Pretty slow greens, but there's a lot of break. These are the clubs. Not too bad. Here's the driving range. I parred the second hole, yay. a hard course. Lots of weird rollouts. Let's see, 234 yards. Par 5. Oh wow, yep. Topped it. Delete. It's a bunch of monkeys. They better not. Wait, no, those are not monkeys. Those are the, what's it called? It's like the native raccoon type animal. I forget what they call it. I want to make sure I get it there. Oh, why go right? I made it over the water though. If I had the right direction. Iguana. The cenote hole. What's this? Hole 6. Oh, that scared me. That little iguana. They do have a cart boy, got an electrolyte. It rains, but it was quick. There's the ball. But the rain brought mosquitoes though, so. But I can't prepare it. I got my Picaridin bug spray. Is that how you say it? Picaridin? Bug spray, and that works. That's my favorite one. Because it's safe on clothes and such too, but. Fun course so far. Kind of hard, but fun. I've only lost one ball so far, and we are, what is this, 11th hole? Yeah, I think so. Look at the water.
made it over the water. At least I made it over the water. Somebody lost their glove. Should we pick it up? It's a foot joy.
Those glass coils are pretty cool.
Yep.
Definitely, I think it's back down.
Yep. More water on the back nine. Y'all, that last sand bunker shot, crazy. The sand was like, you step on it, it was like this deep. I hit like 5 sand shots, but we're not gonna talk about that. Just finished playing, but it was a hard course, definitely a PGA course. It was hard but fun. I didn't go up these steps. I'm tired now though. I need some food. Fun course, super hard. The practice greens were slower, but the actual greens were faster. The QI10s. I normally play, since I'm a beginner, I normally play with the TaylorMade Kalias. But the QI10s were a little stiffer, I think. They were all right. Well, I like my Kalias because that's what I'm used to. The shaft is, yeah, a little bit more flexible for me. Couldn't use Arcos, so didn't get all that club data, but I like my driver better. Oh, it's the same dude. We got the same golf cart driver. Taste the gin. That's a real big shrimp. I'm gonna put my hand for reference. Just like the size of my hand. A little complimentary roll from the chef. Is it good? While we were at dinner, got a little slippers. It's quiet around here. I think this is technically considered their Tulum's shoulder season, so I don't know if it's really shoulder low season or if this hotel is just quieter, but it's really been quiet around here. I'm curious to see, we're switching hotels tomorrow, so we'll see if it's quiet or what, because I was expecting more people than what I've seen so far here. Golf was good today, but it's made me yet again tired, but that's fine. Here's to another 9 in. And also, I wanted to go to Kengai, which is their like Asian. They had a few Thai dishes on there that I wanted to go to, but it was closed, so we ended up going to Yucai, which is more of like
sushi, Japanese type. That didn't really do anything for me. That didn't hit the spot, you know. The food was just okay tonight, but it just, this lighting is bad, huh? But the drink that I got was really good. Didn't really care for the sushi roll. Of course, I don't normally eat, like, when I eat sushi, I like for it to be cooked or semi-cooked. I don't know, that's weird, but I can't do raw. The texture, it messes with me. And that little ramen bowl I got was pretty small. And the shrimp tempura was just plain. Like, if it had like a Thai sweet chili sauce, I feel like that would have made it better, but it was just okay. Another beautiful sunny day, headed to breakfast and then the pool. It's nice and warm. Look at this. Y'all, I'm still full from breakfast. I don't know why I'm looking at the food. What should our first pool drink be? Nice. It rained for a little bit, but the sun is out, sorta, kinda. It's fine. It looks pretty sunny on camera though. We're checking out the Conrad and going to Papaya Ply Project. Yesterday we played golf all day, so this is our first time really being in the hotel pool and facilities. And the service here has been pretty good. Everyone's nice and friendly. So we're in Casa 5, I think it's that second to last building there. So we have a nice close ocean view. Is that a hot tub? It looks like it would be a hot tub. Is it hot? Oh. It's a fake hot tub. I got a strawberry mojito. I considered getting the piña colada, but I like a good mojito. The sun's out. Getting a little bit of a tan out here. It's UV5. Now this is a vibe. Alright, let's try this mojito. That's good. Got little complimentary. What do you say it was? Blended pineapple. You said chamoy in here too? What is chamoy? It's good. Salty. I think they put tahini in here. And we also got a agua de piña. Pineapple water. See that hawk? It's raining. Storming. I wish I'd gotten that hawk flying by. But our view is out that way. Coming down now. Check it out. Goodbye room with a pretty view. I'm excited to go to our next hotel though, so hopefully it's just as good as this one.